Match-Aid, and today we're here at Partridge Lakes for the brand new series New to Fishing. Today is part one, and we're going to be going through about setting up the box, why we set it up, and in future episodes we're going to be going through different tactics and different products which you could use on venues such as this. Today I've got a nice margin to my right, and this is the reason why I set my box up more to the left of my peg. This is so I can get a bit more distance away from my margin, and there's less chance of any spooking fish with any commotion. Now my box is nice and level on this platform. This platform's a really, really level, so it's really easy to get your box set up. I've got two spirit levels, one on the back and one at the side. Now, as you can see, the one on the side is slightly off to the right, and this is because I've set my box, my back legs, about 10 millimetres higher than the rest of the box. This helps for support on your back and doesn't hurt your back as much when you're sat on the box. As regards to actually sitting on the box, you want it so it's your hips are at a right angle to your torso. This is very important, as if it's lower or is it higher, again this will help, this will wreck your back, and it won't be as comfy when you fish.
The reason why it's so far forward today, would you have to always take your foot plate right to the end of the platform?
Yes, this is I put my box straight near the platform because it just gives me that extra bit of distance towards the water, and I can get further out if needs be. So say if I'm all the way back there, if I'm fishing 11 metres, I'll be way shorter than someone who would be fishing up at the edge of the platform, and they'd get further out.
So once you set your box up, would you then be looking at starting getting some ground bait set up, depending on what style of fishing you're doing?
Yes, I'd set my box up first, and then I'd start to mix my ground bait due to the fact that it needs to have time to soak, and like taking all the water. So you'd mix it, taking all the water, and then you'd leave it, set the rest of your gear up, and then come back to it and remix it again.
We'll do a little bit and show everyone.
So. Yes, we will be doing some ground bait mixing. So now I'm about to prepare my pellets. Right, these are the Bait Tech 2mm. I'm just going to pour some in here, and I'm doing these purely for a feed pellet. Now what I tend to do is pour a few in.
What do you say, feed pellets? What is that?
It's just where either I pot it in, or I can throw them in, like not obviously not 2mm, but like 4s and 6s, so I can just throw them in, or just pot them in, or like even in a big cup, like big pot them in,
right,
just to get a better bait down in the bottom. Now 2mm seems to be good because they're smaller particles, which means that fish will be like delving into the ground and trying to find them, so it keeps them in the swim longer. Now what I tend to do is for feed pellets, just pour some water in, pour enough so that they're definitely covered. Make sure they're all down, and then just wait for 10 seconds, that's all they need. Wait any longer, some brands they can go to mush, these ones don't, these are really good. And if you leave them in longer, you can use them on like a method, which because it makes them stickier. Just make sure they're all covered, and then just pour them out. Pour all the water out. There you go, like that. And they should be ready. Now, the reason why you do wet them is because sometimes when you do throw pellets in, they tend to float. Like I said, not all brands do this, these don't. But when you do, when they do, and especially if it's windy, you want the pellets to go down to the down on the bottom. If they're windy, then you can drag fish over to someone else's peg. So if they're flowing into someone else's peg. And also in a lot of venues, you're not allowed floating baits. But by wetting them down, make sure they go to the deck make a nice bed on the deck, and bring the fish into your peg. Now we're going to be mixing ground baits. Now the ground bait I've chosen today is Bait Tech Special G Green. As I said before, I'm going to be fishing down my margin and out, so this is the stuff I'm going to be using. Now, let's pour some of this in. Not going to use too much, about half a bag probably. That'll do. Now what I do now is when I'm mixing it, I don't bung a load of water in straight away, because this will wreck the ground bait. What I do, get the water, I just start ever so slowly trickling it in, and then mix.
On the CD box,
yeah, it just makes life easier. Don't have to be bending down constantly, you know, possibly damaging your back. Just makes life easier. And you keep going. Now, what I'm going to do now is ever so slightly over wet it. Now, this is because, at this point, I've just set my box up and I'm mixing my ground bait. Now, this, by slightly over wetting it, what it does is it makes, while I'm getting the rest of my gear ready, it means that this ground bait can be soaking and taking in all the water. So when I come back to it later, once I've got everything ready, all I have to add is only a slight bit of water to get it to the consistency that I really want. Just a little bit more. Yes, exactly. Now, as you can see with this, it is slightly wet, right? And it's quite sticky. Now, if I leave that now, that will go nice and dry, and possibly might need to add a little bit of water, but that's the best thing with it. It'll take in the water. I know that I need to add a little bit to get to the perfect consistency that I need. So, leave that, get the rest of my gear ready. So I'm fishing shallow on a top kit plus two sections. I'm fishing this short because people who are new to fishing, they're not going to be confident enough to go those distances. So I thought I'd go short to show them that we can actually catch fish really close in. So I'm going to go shallow now, and we're going to see how long it takes me to catch a fish, about 5 to 30 seconds. I have been feeding up a swim. I've just been feeding maggot, just short, and we'll see if I can catch any fish. So I'm feeding about 10 maggots, probably maximum. I'm doing a small pinch. I'm just varying the amount that I'm feeding. I've got a double maggot on the hook, with a bigger bait, so you catch bigger fish. Also, it eliminates those small fish that you catch, because they won't be able to take the bait as easy. There we go, the fish. What was that, about 7 seconds, something like that? Lovely little rud. Then feed again, settle the fish. Look at that, quality rud. Check the bait, check it's all nice, and if as it is. And then, go back out again. Couple of slaps. Slapping helps to imitate bait falling, like bait going into the water, like that. And then feed. That just helps to create noise, especially if fish are coming to the noise. And it just instantly takes your bait if that's the only thing coming in to the water. With a lovely rud. Great quality fish in here.
Keep yourselves up to date with
Angling Times, Angler's Mail, Maybe UK, Maybe Match-Aid. Give us a like on Sarah Taylor Fishing. And Match Fishing TV with Matt Godfrey, Tom Scully, and Joe Carras.
And I think that's Roger, isn't it?
Yes.
Fantastic show. Loads out there for you, so keep yourselves up to date. Get your interest going. Everything to get you lot out here on the bank and having fun and enjoying the fishing. Until then, guys.
Bye.